Hello, welcome back. Remember the last video we stopped at making our pouch for our purse. Is our purse that we are making, our Ankara leather purse. And there was a slight mistake in the last video. The last video I turned it this way out. This was the part that was facing us, but correct that mistake. It's supposed to be this way out, so that the zip will be out. When you zip it and you look inside, that's what you see. Today now we are going to do the spaces for our credit card. Remember, this is the base we are going to use to form our credit card containers. And essentially, this you will find in the pattern list, but this might not be with the pattern. Essentially, the length that you use to make the spaces for the credit card is about 3 times this panel. It's about 3 times. If you fold it, it's about 3 times the panel. So essentially what we are going to do is this. Let me give you an idea what this panel is and where it will lie. This is the base of our purse. And when we finish making the pockets for the credit cards on top of this, this will lie somewhere like this in the purse. Somewhere like this, so that when you close it, it will become something like this. So that is it. So let's go ahead immediately and form our base for our credit card. What we are going to do now is we are going to join this. The front side is there, and the front side of the base. You put it like this, making sure you have equal space on both sides. Put it like this correctly, and then we sew half an inch here. I'll do that quickly. Do that quickly then. Through with that, as you can see. So quickly we turn it this way. So you can see that this is the front part of it. We turn it and iron it very well to let it lie down very well. I'm going to do a quick ironing now. All this is so that our end product would come out very neat. So we're done with that. We're now going to make the pouches for the credit card. You can use credit cards that have expired. Please don't use your normal credit card. So use credit cards that have expired to do this. Hope you're seeing it very well. So, first, you place the cards exactly as I'm doing. The space between the two should be almost the same. And then you fold in such a way that you leave a little space showing the credit cards. Leave a little space showing the credit cards and iron. So try to use credit cards that have expired so that in case it melts, don't cause a problem for you. Okay, remove it, place it again to the second space. Fold again. Try to ensure that the folding is equal, one side is not more than the other. Can move it now. As you can see, we now have what we need to be putting our credit cards. Here, we are going to fold this neatly, cut off a little of this. I will continue that in the next video. Let's get this all done so that there won't be too much confusion. Continue that in our next video.